Hello, whistleblowers everywhere. So today's tune breakdown is going to be a reel and it's titled The Glass of Beer. Now, I've had a few requests for this one, so I thought, okay, about time we did this one. So as per usual, what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it through a nice steady pace without any ornamentation, save maybe just for a few cuts to separate the notes that are the same. Then we'll start looking at adding some ornamentation, and in the last part we'll have a look at maybe some variations that you can try yourself. So here we go, the glass of beer. So I've set my metronome to 70, which is plenty fast enough for a run through. So here we go. 1, 2, 1. Okay, let's look at this in section by section. So it's a two-part reel. We've got an A and a B part. So let's start with the A part and let's look at adding some cuts and a few long and short rolls. So here we go. So the first measure, we've got a short roll on the B. So we're going F, B, cut, tap. So the next measure. Now on that E, we can either do a short roll or if we want, we can just tap the E. So we can go. Or you can make a short roll out of the E. So the first two measures. So on bar three, we've got that short roll on the B. Then we've got a dotted F. So with the dotted F, what we're going to do is we're going to do a long roll on that. So it's going to go. So note, cut, tap, E. Again. And then the last bar on the first line. Now I like to cut that high A, and again we can tap the E or we can do a short roll. Or it's awkward to go from the F because you've got to play the E and cut it, so you've got to go and cut at the same time, so it's much easier just to put a little tap on that E. Okay, so the whole of the first line. So second line, we've got a lot of repetition, so we've got the same figure. And then the third measure on the first, second line. And again, you can put a high A cut and you can also cut the F. So last bar on the second line. So let's play the whole of the A part now. if you noticed, I was just tapping those E's. Much easier to do that. Otherwise, you have to sort of do a lot of footering around with trying to get the cut. You can do it, but I tend to tongue because it's just much easier. So. Quite nicely like that. Okay, so let's have a look at the B part now. So we're starting on the third line, first bar. So there, what we can do is we can put a nice cram. Now, crans are quite tricky to do, but I'll show you how to do them, but I'll also show you a variation you can do instead of doing the cran. So, cran is middle finger cut, first finger cut, middle finger cut. So you're doing three cuts in rapid succession. Now, some people like to go index, middle, index, and that's absolutely fine as well. You can cran that way. It's the rhythm of the cran. However, you can extend the cran and make it sound a little bit fuller by adding an A cut. So it's almost like a quadruplet. So don't worry too much about crans. It's an option to do them. A lot of whistle players never use them. I like to use them because I'm an Illan piper and it's an Illan piping ornament. So I can just transfer that from the Illan pipe chanter to the whistle and I think it sounds great. However, if you want to avoid that cran, we can just simply turn that. We can go. And there I'm putting a long roll on that F sharp. So rather than going, I can go D, C sharp, D, and then play the E as written. So, okay, so I'll try it both ways. So first way with the D, C sharp, D, E. And now with the cran. Okay, second bar of the third line. So I'm cutting the F sharp. And I'm going to cut the E. You don't have to put that E cut in, you could just cut the F sharp. Or with both. So, first two measures of the third line. Now with the cran. So, third bar. Exactly the same thing, we can cran or we can do that altered D, C sharp, D, E. Or. And then. So I'm cutting the high A and putting a tap on that E on the last measure. So the fourth line is pretty much exactly the same. Apart from the last two notes. So we've got. So we got the D, C to do the turnaround to repeat the tune. So let's do the whole of the B part now. So I'm going to do it with the altered first bar and also with the crown on it. So I'm going to mix it up. So turnaround to bring us back to the first part again. So now I'm going to play it all the way through at 70 with the ornaments we've talked about. Okay, let's have a look at some variations we can put in. And again, variations are something which you can use, or if you like to play the tune just straight, that's absolutely fine as well. Just add a little bit of interest for you as a player and sometimes for the listeners as well. So here we go. First, the first line. So here we can maybe do a series of short rolls on the third line, so we can go. So I'm just doing three short rolls. So I'll play that first line as I just did. So that's a little variation you could put there. Or you could go. Which is written and with the rolls. So the other thing I like to do as well is to carry that figure on that we have in the first measure. So I'm just keeping that going. So as a variation maybe on the second line. So with that, I'm just carrying that figure on. So I'll play the A part with those couple of variations just thrown in. Okay, so we already talked about the B section and changing that crown to. Yeah. So what I'm putting there is a little triplet going C sharp, B, A on that second bar on the third line. Only a little variation, but it's nice to put that in from time to time. So we could go. Yep, same thing. So you could put a long roll on that E and miss out the F sharp and E. So that third line. And again, we got a long cran. Or there, I've just changed that slightly, so I'm going and then I'm going F sharp, G, F sharp, E. So that's the first bar on the fourth line. So as written, with the variation. And then the next line, sorry, the next bar. You can put that triplet again if you wanted. And then we've got that figure again. So you could go, or you could go, if you wanted to repeat that little figure. So I would probably just play the last bar as written because it's nice to have that little as a turnaround. Okay, so I'm going to play the whole tune now. The first time I'm going to play it with just as it's written with the standard ornaments, and then I'm going to put some variations in on the second time. So again, my metronome is set to 70, so it's really slow, so you can see exactly what I'm doing. So playing it through twice, first time as written with the ornaments, second time with some variation thrown in. Okay, so this is the glass of beer at a reasonable pace. Have it, a breakdown of the glass of beer. So if you found this tutorial helpful, this tune breakdown helpful, if you've got any questions, you can leave your questions or comments in the comment section below. If you found this useful, then maybe you would like to subscribe to my Whistleblowers channel. And if you know any whistlers or whistle players or anyone who's got any interest in whistling at all, if you want to send them over to my Whistleblowers channel, that would be fantastic. So if you could like and subscribe, that would be wonderful. So keep a lookout for new content, which is going to be coming up fairly shortly. I'm going to be doing some more tune breakdowns, and also maybe think about joining up with Whistle Club, which is my new endeavor. Monthly tune breakdowns, whistle chat, questions and answers. Just a nice place for whistle players to get together, have a chat, do some tunes, and just generally enjoy playing whistle. Okay, folks, hope to see you all soon, and cheerio for now.